stand and give our chairman, our commissioner, a great round of applause as he comes and delivers the State of the County address. Now, I'll be honest, he told me to say something about the school system. I could have said a whole lot, you all know that, about the school system. Yeah, 70% of the schools beat the odds, test scores are improving, we have less than 50 teacher vacancies. I could go on and on and on. We're working on reading 27,000 kids right now and working on it in addition to what they're doing in the classroom with the teacher, eliminating skill deficits in reading and math. We're doing all of that. Y'all watch out. When I say we're going to be a high-performing school system, we are going to be just that. And I want my team over there to wave your hand. And Commissioner, you have my word that we're going to give you a reason. We're going to give you something to tell folk when it comes to drawing folk, whether it be families or businesses, to this county. That's a promise that I don't mind making. We appreciate you, sir.
For someone who wasn't going to say a lot about the school system, he just did. And we appreciate what you said. Very much so, sir. You know, I am very thankful for Superintendent Beasley. He's energetic and he's a fighter for the rights and education of our children. Let's give him another round of applause. Okay, again, good afternoon, everyone. Dr. Beasley, thank you for the introduction. To all of our elected officials, thank you for being here. Let me also say this about our elected officials, especially our mayors and city council people. I love, respect, and admire each and every one of you and the relationship that we have. So let's give our elected officials, our city counterparts, a round of applause. Dr. Beasley hit it head on when he spoke about the relationship between the county government and the school system. We have a closer working relationship. We are more unified. We are out to make sure that the citizens, our students, our seniors, everyone that lives in Clayton County is provided with a greater quality of life and education system. So the school system, I applaud you again as well. To all the other elected officials, my Clayton County Board, please stand. If you are Clayton County Board of Commissioners, please stand. Let's recognize them for the work that you do. To my Clayton County family, the hardworking young men and women who are employed by Clayton County and our directors, I believe you are here today, please rise so we can give you a round of applause as well. We as commissioners could not do what we do and make this county shine without you. So I appreciate all of your efforts. To my family, who's always here to support me, y'all raise your hand. Let's give my family a round of applause. And my beautiful wife, Darlene, thank you for being that support that you've always been for me through, you know, some hard times and through the times when I'm not there at night and busy with county business. You've always been there in support of me, and I'm thankful to you for that. To the Council for Quality Growth, thank you for putting on this event, as well as the Chamber of Commerce. I couldn't do it without you, and you always make it a quality class act, and I appreciate that. For everyone else who's here, our business owners, the community at large, thank you for being here, and as the superintendent said, you are here in support of me, and that's something I will never forget or take for granted. Thank you for your support. Now, this is an exciting time to be your chairman. And I would like to thank you all for the honor of allowing me to serve you. We've accomplished so much together over the past 5 years, and we should take pride in that. We can be proud that our budget is strong, sustainable, and forward-looking. And while Clayton has been tested by numerous challenges and obstacles, it is a privilege to stand before you again today to tell you how proud I am that the state of our county is stronger than it has been in the past years, despite our challenges. As you may know, Clayton maintains a strong AA2 from Moody's Investor Services and a AA rating from Standard & Poor's. A strong rating not only saves our taxpayers millions of dollars, it's an assessment of the quality of your county government's operations and fiscal strength. Fiscal strength is the foundation for public investment now and in the years to come. We continue to invest in public safety with $84.3 million budgeted. This represents the largest investment by the county. We can be proud that Clayton continues to maintain strong reserves, increasing from $55 million in fiscal year 2016 to $59.3 million in fiscal year 2017. Yes, we have a lot to be proud about in Clayton County. When I took office back in 2013, I promised transparency. Since then, Clayton has been committed to government accountability, transparency, and delivering on our promises. This is proven by our management of SPLOST projects. The county has completed 73.8% of parks and recreation projects and 77.5% of transportation projects. Despite collections for the 2009 SPLOST being under original estimates, projects continue to be implemented and completed. The county's current 2015 SPLOST has completed 52.3% of projects in the 3 years since collections began. Clayton County is in the midst of updating our software systems to streamline mission-critical data and processes. We are looking forward to increased efficiencies, easy-to-use applications, and the elimination of manual processes. We will all benefit from these improvements, and we should be proud of that. Let's take a quick look at what SPLOST projects will begin during this year's construction phase. Now, aren't those projects we can be proud of? Let's give that a round. And because we continue to deliver on promises, our departments are constantly recognized nationally as the best of the best by professional organizations. We can take pride in knowing that for fiscal year 2017, our finance department received both the Distinguished Budget Presentation Award for the 14th consecutive year and Certificate of Achievement for Excellence in Financial Reporting for the 38th consecutive year. This team is led by Ms. Ramona Bivens and her staff. Let's give them a round of applause again. Thank you. These awards are the highest form of recognition in governmental budgeting and financial reporting. However, strong financial standing means nothing without exemplary employees to carry out our mission and vision. Clayton employees are capable, well-trained, and dedicated to providing excellent service to the community. And those employees that are here and those that are out there working hard, they're led by a team by our Chief Operating Officer, Dietrich Stanford. Let's give them all a round of applause as well. Our human resources team serves over 2,500 employees, 37 departments, and approximately 280,000 citizens. Clayton County Board of Commissioners has a competitive recruitment process and is committed to finding the strongest talent. We are proud to be able to present competitive jobs and opportunities to our community. Continued economic development and diversification is a priority for us. Clayton's future success depends on all of us working together to build our community. We must continue to engage and empower our diverse population to lead this effort. Some current projects underway are Clorox, who will make a $42 million investment to the community and bring 85 jobs. The Clayton Center, Commerce Center, on Anvil Block Road will bring hundreds of jobs and a $38 million investment. Low Temp Industries, a company that has been anchored here in Clayton County for over 70 years, has started construction in the city of Jonesboro on a $14.5 million facility. And last, but certainly not in the least, Cummings Power South has begun construction on a $10 million facility, which will create 80 new jobs. 53 existing companies plan to hire an additional 545 employees over the next 12 months and collectively invest another $26 million in Clayton County. The Economic Development Office assisted 557 businesses last year in terms of contact via phone, walk-in, or email. We can be proud that Clayton's labor force has returned to pre-recession levels with an increase from 131,000 to 134,260 over the past year. Our current unemployment rate of 5.4% is near pre-recession levels. And I expect that number to decline even further as the Hartsfield-Jackson International Airport undergoes a $6 billion expansion, and not to mention the great work going on with the Atlanta Aerotropolis Alliance and Aerotropolis CIDs. I see great growth and job opportunities happening all around the airport, especially along the northern corridor of our county. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge Gerald McDowell, who is the director of the Aerotropolis CIDs, and Shannon James, who is the chairman of our board of Aerotropolis. If they are here, let's give them a round of applause, please. Thank you for the great job that you are doing. January 23rd, 2018, was Tourism, Hospitality, and Arts Day at the Capitol to celebrate the record $60.8 billion economic impact that tourism brings to the state of Georgia. And because of our numerous assets and proximity to the Hartsfield-Jackson International Airport, we will continue to be a big player in Georgia's thriving film and tourism industries. In 2017, film productions shot in Clayton County increased from 30 productions to 55, a 60% increase over the previous year. Clayton County has been used as the inspiration and location for many films and television shows, some of them you may have seen, like Spider-Man Homecoming, Baby Driver, The Walking Dead, Stranger Things, and many more. Now, I need to also take another second here to thank Tamara Patridge for all the work that she does. She heads up our film office and does a terrific job. Thank you. Let's give her a round of applause. The U.S. Travel Association and the Georgia Department of Economic Development report the economic impact numbers annually to show what tourism brings to the local, regional, and national levels. Several figures are presented each year, including total economic impact, number of tourism-related jobs, and household tax relief. This year, each of those numbers increased for Clayton County. The total economic impact from direct tourist spending went up 3.7% to $1.4 billion spent by visitors in Clayton County. Employment increased to 34,540 jobs, and the household tax relief also increased to $2,404. The household tax relief represents the annual amount of taxes visitors save residents on services and transportation by spending their money, while traveling in Clayton County. Now, whether you hear it enough or not, Clayton County is a world-class community. Let me say that one more time. Clayton County is a world-class community. We not only offer a great place to work and live, we also offer great places to enjoy. In 2017, we continue to invest in our arts, cultural, and recreational offerings, including further implementation of expanding our parks and trails, such as a new trail connecting the Lake Spivey Country Club to Clayton County International Park and several other trail systems. And we will soon start construction and renovations at the Clayton County International Beach and Park, where a new recreation center and amphitheater will be built. Now, it's no secret that economic development and public safety go hand in hand. Public safety is a necessary precursor to revitalization efforts, and I'm proud of how far we have come. Significant strides were made to ensure that each member of the Clayton County Police Department served the community with their core values of professionalism, honor, integrity, transparency, and commitment. In a continued effort to increase transparency, we outfitted 85% of our uniformed officers with body cameras and in-car camera systems, with the remaining equipment needed to attain 100% scheduled by the fall of 2018. Our E911 Communication Center was merged with the Clayton County Police Department to enhance the overall service provided to every Clayton County resident, business, and visitor. Our E911 Communications Division received over 752,000 calls, with over 80% dispatched within 1 minute. Clayton County Police Department officers responded to over 265,000 calls for service, in addition to making over 35,000 self-initiated citizen contacts. Our traffic unit's proactive patrols resulted in a 20% reduction in fatal accidents on county roadways. Our animal control unit continues to build on the strong established partnerships forged between public safety, our community, and rescue organizations. As a result, euthanizations have been reduced by 90%. Yes, that deserves a round of applause. They have been reduced by 90% while providing a safe environment for animal care, treatment, and adoption. We have also made major renovations at our shelter on Government Circle, such as sealed concrete pads along with a newly installed camera system. And in an effort to help our officers keep our community stronger and safer, the CCPD has an interactive website, claytonpolice.com. The website allows citizens to receive information from the police department via multiple social media outlets, provide feedback on police interactions, locate crime mapping, view updates on community events, and submit crime tips 24 hours a day. Let's have a round of applause for every officer and first responder that works tirelessly to make our community stronger and safer. We must also honor those that are no longer here with us. Through our partnership with the Home Depot, the Clayton County Public Safety Memorial Wall was unveiled at the CCPD headquarters and serves as a permanent reminder of every fallen Clayton County police officer, sheriff's deputy, and firefighter who made the ultimate sacrifice to the county and our nation. When it comes to our youth, our Youth Services Department accomplished some amazing things this past year. They secured more than $8,000 in scholarship and grant money. Yes, go ahead and clap for that. Our Youth Commission ambassadors were ranked third in the state out of 183 participating youth organizations and number one in Region 13 for the State Student Ambassadors Program. We're talking about our students, our kids in Clayton County. In addition to that, they received special recognition from the Secretary of State for their participation in the National Day of Giving Challenge. The Youth Commissioner letters enabled Operation Gratitude to send over 250,000 chock-full care packages to the tens of thousands of brave men and women still deployed overseas in harsh and remote areas. In December 2017, Operation Gratitude celebrated the delivery of the 2 millionth care package. And I would really be remiss if I did not take and pause for a second to say, or to have the veterans to stand up so we can show you our appreciation. If you are a veteran, please stand so we can acknowledge you and thank you for your service. Now let's talk transit. We are currently working on the Clayton County High Capacity Transit Initiative, which will explore different transit alignment and technology options to improve Clayton County's transportation mobility, accessibility, and connectivity to the Atlanta region, and provide greater access to jobs, congestion relief, environmental benefits, and economic development within the county. MARTA has begun identifying goals and objectives for the study based on data collection, technical analysis, and public input and support. This process will define and evaluate a range of potential transit alternatives to best meet the needs of Clayton County. A preferred transit alternative will be identified to conduct an environmental assessment and more detailed technical analysis to prepare the project for future phases of implementation. The High Capacity Transit Initiative study is anticipated to be completed in the fall of 2018. Now, and I get excited when I can brag on the good things our county has to offer. And trust me, there's a lot that I can be proud of. Clayton County residents and businesses can take pride in knowing we have an award-winning water authority whose mission is to provide quality water and quality services to our community. The Clayton County Water Authority uses constructed wetlands for indirect potable reuse, treating more than 20 million gallons per day. Together, the wetlands and the existing reuse program have reduced Clayton County's dependence on water supply by the Flint and Okmulgee watersheds. The Water Authority continues to grow its small local business enterprise program. The program aims to certify small businesses within Clayton County and 10 surrounding counties with the goal to do business with them. The program hosts several networking events and informational workshops throughout the year to assist in supporting small business and increasing program awareness. As part of reporting to you the state of the county, I am pleased to share a proud moment with you regarding countywide solidarity. Recently, Clayton County government, the seven cities, and the Clayton County Public Schools joined together as the Clayton County entities to challenge the Federal Aviation Administration's clarification of its 1999 policy on airport revenue use. This policy clarification places the local sales tax collected on aviation fuels by Clayton County governments and the public schools at risk. Since 1994 and 1997, respectively, Clayton County and Clayton County Public Schools have levied a general sales tax on goods, including aviation fuel. This vital tax revenue, which now exceeds $20 million annually countywide, is used for operational needs and capital projects, including schools. This recent federal clarification mandate, however, requires the Clayton County entities to use this sales tax revenue only for airport purposes, a use that is contrary to the county referendums that authorize the tax, state law, and even the state constitution. As you all know, this fuel tax issue has dominated the local news lately. Governor Deal introduced legislation that would have eliminated aviation fuel from the list of commodities subject to the local option sales tax in East Bloss, and would have provided Delta Airlines with a significant tax break on the state sales tax levy. Those measures were introduced in legislation adjusting Georgia revenue and taxation provisions, providing Georgia taxpayers with significant tax breaks. Together, and I emphasize together, the Clayton County entities and the Clayton County delegation called on the governor and Delta executives to make Clayton County, its cities, and school system whole if the legislation passed. The governor, leaders in the Senate and House, and Delta heard our pleas and agreed to appropriate $27 million as a lump sum grant to make up for the estimated local option sales tax revenue through 2021. And Delta Airlines agreed to make up the $18 million in estimated East Bloss revenue through 2019 if the legislation passed. However, the tax break legislation on jet fuel did not pass after Delta took a public stand and angered the National Rifle Association. As a result, Georgia General Assembly stripped the sales tax impacts from the final revenue and tax bill. Now, the good news is that I have to tell you today is that the county and the cities will still have an opportunity for the $27 million grant through a supplemental budget bill that has passed both houses of the General Assembly. That appropriation provides a safety net insulating the county and cities local option sales tax through 2021, with funding only being subject to the outcome of our litigation challenging the FAA policy that was argued this morning here in Atlanta at the 11th Circuit Court of Appeals, and I have not got an update on it. So when you ask what's the outcome, I don't have an answer for that yet. But if the Clayton County entities win, the appropriation goes away. If we do not prevail, the funds will be available to the county and the cities. Delta and the school system remain in discussions regarding the East Ploss impacts. This legislative relief comes after our recent successful effort in negotiating a stay in the December 8, 2017 FAA policy enforcement date that allows the Clayton County entities to permanently retain over $1.7 million per month in local option sales tax and East Ploss sales tax revenue until 90 days after the matter is decided, should the courts decide in favor of the FAA. To date, that action has saved the Clayton County entities over $5 million. In the coming weeks, the Clayton County entities will start planning for the post-state grant revenue replacement should the FAA prevail in the Court of Appeals. As I come to a close, I truly believe that we have to reach our citizens through the latest trends. Everything is mobile. Our Click Clayton mobile app is available in Apple and Google Play Store. Click Clayton is a tool that allows citizens to replace non-emergency neighborhood issues which are communicated to local government as a form of community activism through a free mobile phone application. Issues can be reported as soon as they are found, and photos of the issues can be sent along with the report. This app makes use of the global positioning system so that the exact location can be included within the report. From street repair to tree damage or code enforcement issues, all of these can be reported and the progress of the work can be monitored. So remember, if you see something, say something. These are just some of our many achievements over the last fiscal year. We are hard at work on a strategic plan to prepare our entire region to adapt to the biggest challenges facing our community so that we can create an even better Clayton County for our children and grandchildren. We will continue to work on addressing all of our challenges head on, like working to further improve transportation, public safety, and bringing even more jobs and businesses to Clayton. I am looking forward to all of the work we are going to do together in 2018 to continue to make Clayton County even greater for this generation and for future generations to come. We are going to make our community safer and more secure. We are going to grow and diversify our economy even more. We are all going to do our part to prepare for the future so that Clayton County will be an even better place for every single one of our residents. Great things are happening in Clayton County. And before I take my seat, let's take another quick look at what's happening. We'll be right back. And I have to thank Jalen for constructing that and putting that together. And I also, before I forget, to thank my new assistant, wherever she's at, Miss Portia Reeves. She might have stepped out. There she go in the back. Give her a round of applause, please. She helped to get a lot of work on this and had to put up with a lot of comments and edits from me, so I appreciate her. All right, so I encourage you all to stay connected. If you're unable to attend our regular Board of Commissioners meetings, we are now streaming live online. We send out informative weekly e-blasts, and Clayton County Television airs 24/7. The state of our county is strong, and together we are making it even stronger. May God bless you all, and may God continue to bless Clayton County. Thank you.